So try to cut through all the conceptual thoughts of past, present, and future, and then try to develop the pure intention by generating devotion, faith, and then the inclination. So in this way, from one's core of one's heart, and that do the supplication prayer, and of course, in generally, all the samsaric and nirvana phenomena are arisen from the emptiness nature. So then, as we have visualized Guru Pama Sambhava above one's head, non-dwell with the one's Guru, and then from his forehead written that white light and dissolve to your forehead, and then purify your body obscuration, and then receive the vast empowerment. And then also think that as from the Guru's throat that written that red light and dissolve to your throat, and through which that all your speech obscuration got purified, and then receive the speech blessing and secret empowerment.
Guru Dukane was a true wrong in Hingar Chembe, sent it to Vatanjipa Tane, then Guru Tujong Tosum, then Sonatin.
And then from the Guru's heart, radiating that bluish light, that which dissolved to your heart, and then feel and think that your mind obscurations are completely purified, and receive the mind and mind blessing, and then the word empowerment, and cultivate the Jaswabhavikasaya, Dharma Gaya. And then from the Guru's that five places, body, speech, mind, and then the navel and secret place, five color, which is kind of multicolor, just descend down and then dissolve into your five places, and through which that all the past accumulated negativities and obscuration, everything got purified, and then received the body, speech, mind, quality, activity, empowerment, and blessing of the Guru. In that way, one have to just think and believe in her. So since all the samsaric and nirvana phenomena are by its nature, it is the emptiness. So that is why whatever we could think or whatever we could visualize, it is possible in that way. So the emptiness is not something like a voidness, like a empty space in the vase. All the samsaric and nirvana phenomena are just arisen by its nature of the emptiness. So since everything is emptiness nature, that is why it is possible that whatever kind of visualizations that we could think of, you know, it can be just created in that way. If it is not emptiness in nature, then of course it is also difficult to visualize anything. So all this phenomena that by its nature one should really recognize or realize as that nothing is permanent, nothing is having inherent existence. It is something like a you know dream or mirage and illusory nature. Whatever sorts of this, our present worldly activity, which we think of something very permanent and very firm, but you know, just eventually all everything is kind of just gone. Someone may have $100 million of dollars, but still, you know, one day everything can be finished. And in present, it seems like it is just have lots of activity, but you know, at the end, there is nothing any essence. So as we are, you know, all these human beings, even which we think it is like existing and permanent, but then one day death happens, it is everything is gone. So at that time, then only our consciousness or the mind, that which is somehow wanders based on their karma, but this our body somehow dissolved into like, you know, atoms. So when we are having all this kind of conversation and where we think we are just hearing those sounds and words, but the moment it is just the sound stopped, then it is just disappeared. So if it is in case something permanent, then it would be existed forever like that, but there is nothing like that. So all the phenomena are exactly something like that. So something which is by its nature impermanence, and then we are, you know, kind of deluded through which we are grasping as permanent. So that is why without arising any sorts of all these afflictive emotion and try to subdue those and then to carry through with the dharma practice is of course, you know, important. So that is why just to receive these empowerments, that there is no any difficulty. It is a matter of how we visualize and how we think. If we could not think properly or could not visualize, you know, properly, then it seems like all those, you know, kind of visualization, receiving empowerment, something very hard or difficult. So in that way, have that devotion, inclination, and faith, and then receive these, you know, four empowerments. So for instance, like where that guru's mind and one's mind mingle together, it is just only to think and then concentrate. There is nothing like to work hard to mix like water or milk or something. So many of you are just thinking that whether it is mixed or not. So it is just for a moment, think that it is mingled together and just abide there. When one's mind have all this kind of rough thought, and then it feels like, you know, it is really kind of mingling together or not, and just in reality, since everything is emptiness, so it is just, of course, you know, very easy. So, like any of those afflictive emotions and five poisons or like pride, whatever sorts of thoughts may arise, if you really look into it, it naturally just dissolves into the emptiness. So, for instance, like you are so angry, just in a kind of rage, that your bodies are trembling and then kind of, you know, shouting so loud. But a moment you look into that anger thought, you know, just it is naturally dissolved in emptiness, nothing is there. So some people are just, you know, so angry and then they started kind of trembling and jumping like that. But if you just look into, you know, just one's own nature or that thought or the object, everything is, you know, by its nature, it is emptiness. So whatever sorts of afflictive emotions or the defilements may arise, if you just really look into it or just investigate, you know, there is nothing, you know, everything dissolves into emptiness. No any kind of afflictive emotion just kind of remains there. So if one could not apply such kind of method to just to dissolve into emptiness, and then maybe it is looks like the afflictive emotions are something very concrete. So in case it is something very concrete, then you better just burn in the fire and use some hammer to chop it down. So actually there is nothing like that. So anyway, all the time that examine your thoughts, mind, and don't let be under the control of all those afflictive emotions. Just one have to be very careful about that. For instance, like if one have, you know, many hundreds of millions of dollars, maybe one feel kind of, you know, happy. But still, you know, just when you look into that nature of happiness, again, it is also, you know, emptiness in nature. So someone who is very poor, beggar, that who doesn't have anything to eat or just wear or, you know, kind of no house and still being very sick, of course one may feel very sad. So that also just a moment when oneself experiencing in that way, it seems like a kind of, you know, sadness, but in reality, if one look into it, it is also emptiness in nature. So in this way, as we just examine all this samsaric and nirvana phenomena and all sorts of, you know, existence is by its nature, you know, emptiness. So at the same time, one always try to give rise to, you know, compassion, loving kindness to all sentient beings, and also try to concentrate into the practices of the four immeasurables, and then generate the aspiration bodhicitta and application bodhicitta and so forth. You know, just one have to train one's mind in that way. And then sometimes when you have time, then whenever you just exhale through your nostril, then together with that you send all your happiness and virtues and meritorious together, and then just, you know, really think that it dissolves to all sentient beings. So, and then think that they all experience that happiness and joy. And then also when you just inhale, then together with that inhalation, you just think all sorts of, you know, just bad conditions, negativity, sickness, problems, and all the non-virtues of, you know, all sentient being, together with that, you know, just air, inhalation, just dissolve to oneself, and then think that all sentient beings are liberated from such a suffering and experience that actual peace.
Tana sa deretam machave chido, rangi ledip taba chido, sanam cheba le chod cheba chides.
So even this, in the, what say, this tonglen, the meditation practice on that inhalation and exhalation, that if you could do, you know, concentrate your mind about seven times, you know, in a day, it is a very good method that which helps to purify all your karmas and negativities. So within this present life, with this human support, the most important thing is that we could to do some dharma practice to accomplish, and that way always just try to generate compassion, loving kindness to all sentient beings. In that way, just doing these practices, not necessarily we need some separate time. And if one thinks, oh, I'm just great, I'm great scholar, and something, just thinking oneself is something very special, and developing that pride or ego, then just nothing much one can just really accomplish. Not just only the, you know, just the dharma, of course, that even the worldly activity also one cannot really accomplish. Even it is also difficult to have a kind of, you know, good friend.
That didn't send him.
So that is why all the time to have a very relaxed mind is important. So you all somehow that for many years now, you know, involved all these Dhamma practices, even though I don't know much that I have explained and taught whatever that could, you know, benefit you. So you have to just, you know, take it as to apply as a practice. So I'm not using any kind of, you know, just power and saying, but just really thinking that may benefit for this lifetime or for the next lifetime if you just apply in practice.